Good morning, dear students. Today the topic is kinematics of mechanisms. So in this, mainly to concentrating on the velocity and accelerations. Okay, velocity and accelerations of the mechanisms. So just all of you observe that. So here generally we have to find out our velocity and accelerations by the help of two methods. Those are the instantaneous center method and relative velocity method. So in this, let us know the instantaneous center. So what is mean by instantaneous center? Simply to say that a moving body defined as that the center which goes on changing one instant to another. The center which goes on changing one instant to another. So that is known as the instantaneous center of the moving body, instantaneous center. So in this, the locus of all such instantaneous centers is known as the centroid. The locus of all such instantaneous centers is known as the centroid. It is calling as centroid. It is very important. What is meant by centroid? What is meant by centroid? Simply to say that the locus of all such instantaneous centers is known as the centroid. And in this, we have the two types of centroids are there. Those are the space centroid and body centroid. Space centroid and body centroid. So coming to the space centroid, so the locus of instantaneous center in the space, the locus of the instantaneous center in space during definite motion of body, during definite motion of body is called space centroid. Later, body centroid. Body centroid means the locus of instantaneous center relative to the body itself. Relative to the body itself is called body centroid. Body centroid. These are the two types of centroids are there. Now coming to the properties of instantaneous center. Properties of instantaneous center. Mainly to take the two types of, two properties are there. Those are the first one. A rigid link rotates instantaneously relative to another link at the instantaneous center for the configuration of the mechanism. So what the link is considered here? Rigid link rotated instantaneously relative to the another link. So that is consider as the by the help of our instantaneous center. So that is the one property. And another one is that the two rigid links have no linear velocity relative to each other. What are the links are there? Those two are rigid. Those two are not having any relative velocity to one to another. So that is also the one of the property is there in our instantaneous center. So instant, assume that instantaneous center, that means the center is changed. The center is changed one instant to another instant. So the one action to another action. So for example, let us take the one mechanism. So that is the four bar chain mechanism is there. So when it is in rigid mode, so that means when it is in stationary mode, so that may also have the some instantaneous centers. And while it is also going to be in dynamic or running mode, so then though they may also changing the instantaneous centers. So that those are also indicating here. So those are the instantaneous. The center is also changed to instant, one instant to another instant. That is the instantaneous centers. And centroid means the locus of all instantaneous centers is calling as the centroid. So that is a space centroid and body centroid also there. Now going to see the types of instantaneous centers. Types of instantaneous centers. So here, we have the three types of instantaneous centers are there. those are the fixed instantaneous centers, permanent instantaneous centers, neither fixed nor permanent instantaneous centers. So how we identify the those instantaneous centers? Forgetting those instantaneous centers, let us take the four bar chain mechanism. So just all of you observe the four bar chain mechanism here. So in this four bar chain mechanism, they may also represented their instantaneous centers. Those are the, how many links are there in our four bar chain mechanism? Four links are there. In the one link is fixed, that fixed link is already there. One link one is fixed, and link two, link three, link four links are there. So where we are the joining of, connected to the one and two. So that is also indicating with the one instantaneous center, that is the I12, that is represented with I12, and one and four connection, connecting of the our one and four, that is the I14, and connecting of two and three, that is taken as the I23, and connecting of three and four, so that is considered as the I34. So four instantaneous centers are there. In this, so we have to find out the how many instantaneous centers are there for our particular mechanism. So for getting the instantaneous centers, so let us take the one formula is there. So that is the n into n minus 1 by 2, n into n minus 1 by 2. N means here number of links. N into n minus 1 by 2. So number of links, how many links are there? Four links are there. So 4 into 4 minus 1 by 2. That means we have six instantaneous centers. Are there for our four bar cyclic chain. But in our diagram, already you have the four instantaneous centers. Four instantaneous centers are there. What about the other two instantaneous centers? How we represented the those instantaneous centers? So just all of you observe that. When we are extension of the, when we are extension of the our, our I12 are, our first link and third link. First link and third link. And when we are extension of second link and fourth link, So then they may also achieve, other instantaneous centers. Then they may achieve other instantaneous centers. So just all of you observe that. What are the fixed instantaneous centers? Those are indicating here. Which are the fixed instantaneous centers? What are the instantaneous centers are located at the fixed link? So those are the I12 and I14. So those are the fixed instantaneous centers. And permanent instantaneous centers. So those are the, I23 and I34. So that means those are also represented in our particular configuration mechanism, configuration diagram. So configuration diagram. So those are the I23, I34. I23 and I34. Those are the permanent instantaneous centers. And neither fixed nor permanent. So just observe that. Those are the I13 and I24. I13 and I24. These are the neither fixed and nor permanent. I24. So when we are extension of the our 2-4 link, and when you are extension of the our 1-3 link. So those are the I24 and I13. So those are the neither fixed nor permanent. So neither fixed nor permanent means they may also change their positions when the mechanism will happen. So they may also change their places. So that may also happen. So that's why neither fixed nor permanent are there. Now coming to be here, so how we find out the our number of instantaneous centers of our configuration mechanism, and which are fixed instantaneous centers and which are permanent and which are neither fixed nor permanent. So those are already okay, those are discussed here. Now going to tell the another topic, that is the Kennedy's theorem. So that is main statement is there. So that is the, it states that if three bodies may move relatively to each other, then their three instantaneous centers lie on a straight line. So that is also happened in our particular Kennedy's theorem. So three bodies, just you may also consider as the three bodies. Let us assume the only three bodies are there in our mechanism. So when we are having the three bodies, those are also seems to be this type. So what is the diagram is here? So that is the this is the three bodies are there, A, B, C, three links are there. Those three are relatively to one to another. So and they may also when we are having the three links are there, first you have to find out the number of instantaneous center. So that is the n into n minus 1/2. So that is the 3 into 3 minus 1/2. So that the value is 3. So 3 instantaneous centers are there. In this, intersection of A and B link, connection of A and B link is the AB. Connection of A and C is the AC. Connection of B and C is the IBC. 3 instantaneous centers are identified here. But the thing is, what the instantaneous centers are there, those all must lie on a straight line, but IAB, IAC, both are in straight line, but IBC is away from the our particular line. But they may said in our statement that IBC is also lie on a particular this line, straight line. So IBC is also coming to be this straight line. So only that may also place it to the only straight line. So that may also happen in our particular theorem. Now you will also remember the basic formulas for completing of the these problems. So those are the have the some relations are there. Those are the angular velocity to the our velocity, linear velocity to the our angular velocity. What is the relation is there? V equals to omega r. Do you know that? What is the relation between the angular velocity to linear velocity? V equals to omega r. That is the relation is there. And acceleration. So that is the two types of accelerations are considered, tangential acceleration and normal acceleration, radial acceleration. So that is the, so acceleration point of view, v is a equals to v square by r. A equals to, when we take the our tangential, so that is the our v equal a equals to at equals to our v square by r. That is the relation is also there. and radial acceleration point of view. Okay, radial point of view. So that is the a equals to our omega square r. So those are the basic formulas already. Okay, came in our earlier subjects. So those are the relations are there. What is the relation between the linear velocity to our angular velocity, and what is the relation between the our acceleration to the our velocities? Acceleration to the our velocity. So those are the general basic fundamental formulas are there. So now coming to the our problem. All of you read the problem. Locate all the instantaneous center of the slider crank mechanism as shown in figure. The length of the crank OB and connecting rod AB are 100 mm and 400 mm respectively. The crank rotates clockwise with an angular velocity of 10 radian per second. 10 radian per second. Find velocity of slider at A, and the second one, angular velocity of connecting rod. Angular velocity of connecting rod. So those are the determining values are there. So just read the problem. Just read carefully, and now we have to write the our given values. So those are the crank radius is there. OB equals to 100 mm. Connecting rod AB. Connecting rod length is there. So that is the AB equals to 400 mm. Okay, and angular velocity, crank angular velocity, so that is the 10 radian per second is there. Crank, okay, angular velocity. So omega OB equals to, omega OB equals to 10 radian per second, and OB is there, that is the our radius of crank, 100 mm is there. So that is converted into meters. So that is in meters. So 0.1 meter. Now going to find the velocity of crank. Velocity of crank. So when we have to find out the velocity of crank, VOB equals to relation already there. Omega into R. So that is omega already there. Omega, okay, angular velocity of crank. That is the omega OB into OB. Crank, okay, radius is the OB. So 10 into 0.1. So 1 meter per second. Okay, velocity of the crank is the 1 meter per second. Now you have to find out the instantaneous, number of instantaneous centers. So in our slider crank chain mechanism, we have the four links are there. So just substituted the those number of links in our formula. So then simply to get the number of instantaneous centers are 6. Number of instantaneous centers are 6 here. Okay, do you understand? Now going to see the our configuration diagram. It is very important. Okay, just you may also draw the our slider crank chain mechanism. In our slider crank chain mechanism, if they mentioned, okay, if they mentioned their crank angle, you may also okay, place it the, okay, you should also represent their crank angle. But if they not mentioned, then simply to take the 45 degrees angle with the IDC, 45 degrees half with the IDC. So just okay, fixed link is there. Okay, fixed link is there. Just fixed link is there, and crank length, crank length is 100 mm. So that means just you have to take the scale. So that is the So crank, what is the value is there? Crank velocity is there. Crank velocity 1 meter per second. So 1 meter per second equals to 2 centimeters. 1 meter per second equals to 2 centimeters. Let us take the scale. 1 meter per second equals to 2 centimeters. Later, with the inclination of 45 degrees, with the inclination of 45 degrees, with the inclination of 45 degrees. Now, just observe the diagram. Okay, now let us take the UK started with the this is started with the O. OB is also constructed with the help of 2 centimeter and with the inclination of 45 degrees angle, with the inclination of 45 degrees angle. And then AB length already there. AB is the 400 mm. So in this, it is considered as the 100 mm is also considered as the 2 centimeter, and in this 400 is also considered as the hour. So nearly to take the value, so that is the hour. 8 centimeter length, and just you may also arrange the particular length 8 centimeter to the compass and cut the our horizontal line. Cut the horizontal line. So then you may also achieve the point, the slider at A. So that is the O is there, B is there, A is there. So this is the our O is the our fixed center, fixed link. In this, OB is acting as the crank and AB is our connect. AB is the connecting rod, and A, particularly to the A, is also slider. So are there. Now you have to identify the instantaneous centers. For getting the instantaneous centers, so already there are 6 instantaneous centers are there. So from the instantaneous centers, in this fixed one is the 1 and crank is the 2. So connection of the connecting of the our 1 and 2 link is the I12. So that is there. And 2 and 3. So connecting rod and crank is there. So that is also 2 and 3. So that is the I23. And here 3 and 4, slider and our connecting rod. So I34 is there. So three instantaneous centers are represented. And what about the other three? So in this, when we are having the slider in our arrangement, so that slider is also one of the link. So that slider, okay, so that is the our four is there. Okay, four is there and fixed link one is there. So where we have the sliders are there, that slider place, okay, so that one of the instantaneous centers arranged here, so that is the I14 is there. So that is perpendicular to the our horizontal, perpendicular to the our horizontal. So I14 is the here, this place and our fixed place also, fixed link also. So that is the our okay. So that means the slider will move towards, okay, left and right. Okay, left and right direction. So that instantaneous center is also going to be, okay, that is also varying. So where it is, we cannot say exactly, but that place is also there. Okay, that is always translating to this way. Okay, that is the our I14 and I14. We have to fix it to fixed link place and at our slider place. I14 is there. So that is the four are identified here. What about the other two? So that is the our just all of you up to that. Intersection of our link two and our link four. So just observe that. So what is the link is there? So that is the our link three, just extension of the link three up to our I14. So the link three extended up to our link, okay, up to our instantaneous center line I14. So when we are extension of this one, so then that is also intersecting to the our I14 line. And what is that? So that is indicated with I24. Why? So how we indicating I24 is there? So that is the, so just observe that this place is the I23 and this is the I34. Just right here. I23 by I34. I34. Just all of you observe that 33 is also eliminating. 33 is eliminating. And what about the other? So I24. So that is also okay to attain here plus particular place to achieve the I24. Okay, that's why we are also representing with I24. Now just extension of link two. Extension of link two up to our I14 line. So when we are extension, so that may also intersect at one place. So that may also intersect it to the one place. And how we are identified, that is okay, I13. So that is I13. How we say that I13. So just observe that. So in our this one and this one, so that is the I12 is there into I23 is there. So 2 are eliminating here. The remaining, okay, value are represented here. The remaining thing is the represented here. So that is the I13. Okay, I13 is okay, located to the at this place. I13 is located to the this place. Okay, do you understand how we find the instantaneous centers?
how you find the hour instantaneous center, neither fixed and nor permanent instantaneous centers. Those are the neither fixed and nor permanent instantaneous centers. So those are the I13 are there. Now, so when we find out the hour neither fixed and nor permanent instantaneous centers, now going to make the problem. So just all of you observe from the figure I13A. So what is the length of I13A? Just measure it by the scale. Okay, just measure the value of I13A. So I13 is there and A is there. So just measure the value. Just measure the value, this value. So that is nearly to come 920 mm. So that means how much of length it is? 9.2 cm. Nearly to come 9.2 cm. So that means it is a when we have the 920 mm, so then simply to say that that value is the our 0.46 meters. And similarly to find the our I13B, this up to this one, this length. So just measure the I13B. So that length is So that means 11 centimeter length is there, 11 centimeter. So when you have to 11 centimeter, then simply to put it 0.55 meters. That is the, that value is the 0.55 meters. That is the I13A is there and I13B is there. Just keep it in your mind. I13A is there, I13B is there. Now going to find the hour, okay, velocity of slider at A. So just we will take the hour, okay, formulas, okay, basic formulas. Those are the, we know that VA by I13A equals to VB by I13B. VA by I13A equals to VB by I13B. So that means, so VA by I13A, so that is the our radius, okay, VA by our I13A length and our VB by I13B length. So VA equals to VB into I13A by I13B. So VB value already there, so that is the our velocity of cranking. So that is the one. And I13A is the 0.46 and I13B is the 0.55. So from that 0.836 meters per second of the our slider, of our velocity of slider. So what is the value to achieve here? So velocity of slider is the our 0.836 meters per second. So that is the one determining value. Later another determining value is there, angular velocity of connecting rod, angular velocity of connecting rod. So the connecting rod is represented with AB. So that means omega suffix AB, okay, that is the our determining value. So for getting the omega suffix AB, it may also, okay, taken as the our VA by I13A. So that means this is the I13A, means it is also written as R. It is also written as our R value. So VA by R, omega AB equals to VA by R, R VB by R. Okay, VB by R. So when we take the our VA by R place VA by I13A and our VB by I13B. VB by I13B. So in this, what are the known values are there? So that is the VB already there. So VB is the one and I13B. I13B is the our 0.56. So just those two values are substituting in our equation. Then simply to achieve the our angular velocity of connecting rod, that is the 1.78 radian per second.
Is it clear? Do you have any queries regarding the problem?